Hi, everyone. It's Sarah from Plan Sarah Plan, and welcome to my plan with me for June 17th through the 23rd. I'll be planning my Erin Condren Hourly Life Planner and decorating with a sticker kit from Boulder Bond. This one's called Sunset Beach, and I'm loving the colors. So I have so many stickers here, thanks to the generosity of Bonnie and her shop. And she sent me a journaling kit, and all I requested was the vertical or hourly kit. But I'm going to show you everything I've got here in case you're interested. And if you do bullet journaling, if you use journaling kits, you're going to like this. So here are the full boxes that come with the vertical kit. Here are the check boxes with little seashells. This one is from the journaling kit, so they're a little mixed up here. But look at the art. How pretty. This is from the vertical kit, and it's like functional stickers. This is from the vertical kit, date covers. Here's more from the journaling kit. And here are the thick and thin washies, as well as little headers and deco from the vertical kit. These are washi strips that are kind of thick and torn. Gorgeous, just gorgeous. These just look like art that you could decorate an envelope with if you're sending somebody a card, or use in your daily duo, your journal, your notebook, your any kind of planner. Just really pretty. And this is deco, so I think it's just called deco, not really called journaling kit. I love those. This is florals from the Sunset Beach kit. So even though they are florals, they still have this cast of light that's coming from the sunset. And then these look like big images, like four different images, because they are, but each one has a bunch of skinny washi tape in it. So like four or five strips of skinny washi in each one. Check out these headers. So June, notes, goals, and lists, and then a monogram for each one of those. And this is deco from the journaling kit. So many things, way more than I'm going to be able to use in this one spread. But we're going to start with date covers. I am not as far behind as I was last week, but I do have company from out of town. My brother and sister-in-law are here, and we have had a wonderful several days of time with them, and had a baby shower on Saturday, and my brother wrapped the gifts that I was taking to the baby shower, which really helped me because they were kind of big. And then he also helped me with a food dish that I was taking to the shower, and found a great recipe, helped me go get the ingredients. And he's just really helpful. Everything that I needed to get done, he was like, okay, what's stressing you out? How can I help? Very sweet. He's like the world's greatest brother. And if you have a good brother, tell us in the comments what is great about your brother. What sort of characteristics make you really proud of your brother and really grateful to have him? All right, so we're going to start with these. I usually don't, but we're going to start with these, and then we will decorate after we've changed the dates from blah to ah. So I've got two daughters-in-law who are, now I'm covering up Juneteenth, but I will remember this is Juneteenth. Those daughters-in-law are pregnant, both expecting. One is expecting in August, the other is expecting in December. So I am the world's happiest grandmother because of that. And I also have our grandson who is almost two, and he has been calling me Nene. And I'm kind of getting attached to Nene, but like he's trying to say granny, and all he can manage is Nene. But he also has another grandmother who is Grammy, and he also calls her Nene. So I hope it doesn't get ugly and we don't have to fight. That was definitely a joke because Grammy is also the sweetest person ever. Now I'm going to try something super crazy that I've never done before, and I haven't practiced this at all. So what I'm doing is covering up a tiny bit of those hours just to see what it looks like. It stretches from 6:30 to 6 p.m. So not sized to do this, but what I think might be cool is if I take that off and cover up times with it. So let's just do this. Let's pretend like we don't need times. And on Tuesday, we'll see what it looks like to put one of those skinny vertical strips on top of this. And we'll treat this like a vertical planner and see if it works. Okay, so let's start at the same spot. But now you won't see the AM and PM sticking out because of the whiteout. There we go, I like that. So let's pull this one up and do the same thing. All right, this is an experiment, so we'll see how that turns out in the end. All right, I wanna put down as many full boxes as possible to get just a big old sunset effect. And I think that we want to put these two and these two together. So we'll do them here and here. Start with that. And because these are sized for vertical, there's going to be a little bit of a gap between the two. And that won't bother me if it doesn't bother you. I love the VW bus. That is so cute and retro looking. There's a surfboard on top and a sunset out there. The ocean's out there. And especially a nice sunset in this scene. It's a two-box scene. Now, which one of you was it who said that they hoped that the kit I was getting from Boulder Bond was Sunset Beach? Because you already have that kit. And when I was planning out which kits I was going to use for the month of June, I didn't yet know what I would have from Boulder Bond. And it did turn out to be Sunset Beach. So which one of you was that? All right, here are the four that we have left. We can use one up here as a focal point, maybe the palm tree, and then we can use these three for the remaining days. Let's do it that way. The palm tree is a little different in its coloring overall than these others, so let's do that. And we don't even need to keep the June showing because we know it's June. All right, so we're gonna go with some flowers. I'm gonna put the two flower stickers together on the weekend because one has flowers in the top left corner, the other one has them in the bottom right corner, and I think those will make a nice duo. Yes, and the ocean pretty much lines up on those two. And then we'll put the surfboards on Monday. Really cool. Now let's put this sunset up at the top. We have the people walking here with the ocean that way. I'm thinking maybe I want to put the flowers on the outside. So let's put this one on the right and this one on the left. And I'm going to be trimming off some of this one on the left. So we'll have to decide whether we want to trim off flowers or ocean. And let's start this right around the 7 o'clock line, like that. And then let's see if we want to keep the flowers or keep more ocean. Oh, I think I need to keep more ocean because this will sort of connect. So we'll put this down and then trim the excess that we don't need over here with a handy scraper. And then we'll put the leftover on the sticker scraps page. This is like my artsy, not really artsy, but just fun page. Okay, I'm liking how this looks. All right, I've never really done this, I don't think. Let's take the skinnier washi tape and put it in the middle. So let's just divide this in half and have morning and afternoon. And I think the middle is really on top of a line. If I go above that line, I'm going to have a shorter morning. I'd rather have the longer morning, honestly. I mean, I think. And we're probably going to do a to-do list sort of a plan with me instead of an hourly or appointment sort. But that kind of remains to be seen. Is this the right place? I think it is. Now, I could get really detailed and trim this so that we see the vertical lines, but I don't think I'm going to do that, but I could. And no sooner did I say that than I went ahead and trimmed the little bit so that I could see the vertical lines. I had to see what that looked like. Okay, so now I'm doing little headers. I don't know why, don't know what I'm going to use them for, but I'm just doing it. And I noticed that when I put these vertical stickers on, it makes the width of the hourly, what's left of it after that sticker, pretty much exactly this width, which is an inch and a half. So that's kind of a fun bit of information if you happen to be interested in that. And I'm covering up whatever whiteout was sticking out, at least on this line. Okay, let's put the weekend banner down. And I think the bottom half is where I'm going to put it this week. Okay. Actually, two more because I remembered that these are just the right size to fit in these habit boxes. If you have the hourly version of this planner, by the way, if you're new here and you want to try a nice planner like this Erin Condren, look down in the video description because I have a $10 off referral link for you that works on your first purchase. Okay, so I think I'm finished with these for the time being, and now we're going to fill out events and to-dos. That's about all I can think of right now. I have a little to-do list that I'm nervous about putting here, which is where I want to put it, because my memory verse is quite long. It's this one. So I wrote it in tiny writing there when I was running out of room. So if I did that, maybe I should be able to fit it there. Let's go ahead and take a chance and put it right down on top of this top habit tracker. And we're going to write small from the get-go with the memory verse. In fact, I may put the header on the bottom part of the sticker so that it gives me just a little bit more room. Plus, I covered up June, so that opens up some room. Okay, so I need to work on Etsy orders every morning, except today I worked on them in the afternoon. So let's put it down here today. I'm just thinking of this as morning, afternoon. The electrician came this morning and it was a mom day. And Wednesday will be, actually not Wednesday, Thursday will be a mom day, and she's got a luncheon. So we're gonna put that lunch right under that divider. And then I have lunch on Tuesday. This one's at 1, but I'm not going to worry about times. I just wrote the time on the sticker. And I have piano lessons at 4 on Wednesday. And I need to film my last plan with me in this planner, hopefully Friday morning. Can't believe it. There's one more week in this planner. We are going to have a pizza party with family tomorrow evening. And we have a church sticker. We'll put it that at the late morning. Then Mom Day, a third one. Let's make it Let's do, I think she would rather me see her on Friday than Wednesday, since we're going to do a Thursday lunch. And then the rest of the stickers are Etsy orders, which I want to do in the morning. So let's do Etsy orders here. We'll go back and forth between peach and light blue. No, we won't, because all we have left is peach. Okay, and that's it. That's all I can think of that I have to do, and I'm super stoked about that. All right, so we've got some deco that we probably want to use. Like, definitely this little minivan. And I like the beach chairs. Put those here. And the seashells. Let's put those with church. Well, let's put one with church and the other one with piano. And surfboards. How about we lean the surfboards against this divider? Like that. And we have some flowers, which we might decide to use. But let's go ahead. And of course, there's a whole lot of stuff that I haven't written down. Like, that's just a routine that we do every day. Like, our morning routine, I get up and I have my quiet time. I've been getting better about getting up again, like I used to get up early. So this is all like morning routine and quiet time up here in the beginning of the day. So let's go ahead and put the memory verse down. I have been writing it just once because it's Monday. I wrote it this morning during my quiet time, and I don't remember it yet. But it's about when Saul, who was also known as Paul, was not yet a believer in Christ, and he was persecuting the Christians. And it says, meanwhile, Saul was still breathing out murderous threats against the Lord's disciples. He went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, so that if he found any there who belonged to the way, whether men or women, he might take them as prisoners to Jerusalem. And that's from the 9th chapter of Acts, verses 1 and 2. It goes in the sidebar. Just barely fit in there. Now I've got this to-do script, and I'm thinking it might be cute to kind of offset it right here vertically. I think that's somewhat cute. And we have a clothesline, and I didn't put laundry on here anyway, anywhere. And generally, I like to do laundry when I'm filming. So let's take a look at where I decided to film. I could also be doing laundry this day. And I think it kind of goes without explanation because of the cute picture. And then movie night plan. We can also use the planner on that event right here. That's a cute little planner. And I just noticed that there are a bunch of these little dots here. I should remember that they're always there. Looks like we have 9 of them. And I could write morning routine with a little dot. So let's do that. Since we're at the end of Monday, I can go ahead and check off that I did wake up early and I did pray. So speaking of prayer, what I like to do at the end of my weekly plan with me is say a prayer for the upcoming week, and I invite any of you who want to join me. Father in heaven, bring us into your presence now as we join together in prayer. This is a day that you have made, and we ask that you would help us to be joyful and glad in it. Through the power of your Holy Spirit, please search our hearts and minds and intercede on our behalf. Help us to repent where we have sinned in thought, word, or deed. Help those of us who are ill to place our health in your loving hands and to trust you through every pain, test, and treatment. Help those of us who are in any kind of trouble to cast our cares upon you, and to know that you will never leave nor forsake us. Help those of us who have loved ones in danger or sickness to be faithful in prayer and constant in showing your love and compassion. Help your children around the world to be fortified and strengthened by immersing ourselves in your word and keeping ourselves in continuous contact with you. Give us patience to wait for your answers and solutions to all that concerns us or weighs us down. Give us grateful hearts and train us to offer the sacrifice of praise throughout each day. Make us more like you today than yesterday, as well as more obedient, trusting, and kind. Forgive us our sins as we also forgive those who sin against us. Beautify our lives with goodness, holiness, and uplifted spirits. Rid us of all that is not befitting a child of God. Cleanse us and make us new with the precious blood of Jesus. And bring your kingdom to this world so that we live in your love, truth, and peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Couple of things. One of our new grandbabies is 33 weeks along on Tuesday, tomorrow. I'll just put it right here. And the other one is 16 weeks along, the size of an avocado. Put that one right here. And then I will remember this is Juneteenth, but I might as well just write it in. And now here's a slow motion flyover for you so you can see the details of this BoulderBond kit up close. If you decide you want to get a BoulderBond kit or any stickers from BoulderBond, Bonnie has given us a discount code that I can share with you. It's Sarah15, and that gets you 15% off in her store, which is at boulderbond.com. And that's going to do it for this plan with me. I have another new video up today, and that is the Brain Dump Journal from Cultivate What Matters. I filmed that right before this plan with me. Here is a little sneak peek. What a cool book, especially if you are a list person. If you get overwhelmed and you want to just kind of use a method to get things off your mind and down onto paper, take a look at my review of this item. And I do have a discount for you on that. So if you'll see the discount on the review video, but it's just Plan Sarah Plan, all one word. Thank you guys for joining me, and I will see you again next time. Bye-bye.